All right, we're back for part three of the series. We have once again that organic candy, which is absolutely beautiful. I love working with House of Color for this reason. It dries instantly. You can do graphics, but you have to ventilate the room. You really have to get the stuff out, And since I'm making a video, then I'm doing it here on a table and trying to keep the fumes down. I'm wiping the candy, and as you can see, I've already darkened the flames. And it's a fun process. Again, I think it's that roller coaster when you're painting. One minute you're up, and the next minute you're down. Anything can go wrong at any minute, and so that's, I think, what makes it exciting. As a builder, and okay, here's that antifreeze candy that I make from using about 25% organic candy, and then oh, the dogs are approving of all of this, and then lime green, and you mix them together, and you get this antifreeze type of color. And you use it just once again to create depth, but also to push back that intense bright yellow, which eventually you're gonna want. You're gonna want some of that brightness on there as highlights. Again, the scale is very limiting. There you go. That's much better. The first time it was a little bit too dark, so I added more lime gold to it. All right, and it's flowing nicely. You can see the color there, really bright. And so I'm hitting up the spoon on the right because that one had the bright yellow. And there it goes. You don't have to bomb it. You could just add to it's like cooking again. You add spices to flavor to taste, the same way with painting. You spray with the airbrush until you think you've got the right effect, and that's it. And believe it or not, it dries so fast. You could check it, you could clean it after every pass. It moves quickly with this paint. It moves very quickly. I like it for this reason. But as I said before in another video, there are people who do this a lot better, in part because they have a better command of the airbrush, and in part because they're artists with the airbrush. There's some people who draw with this thing, and they paint with it, and it's a regret. Like, I never learned to play the drums, which is my favorite instrument. I did go to art school for a while, but I really never used an airbrush until I was an adult. So, we're back with the templates now here, just adjusting, tightening as we go along, tightening, 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 making sure that that the airbrush is not spitting or anything like that. Eventually, there we go. And again, there's no method to this madness. If I can do it, you most certainly can. Because every time I do it, it's like a first time. You're never, you can get proficient in this, but it's always going to be very nervous time to get this stuff right. And actually, now that I'm looking at this, after having shot the video, I can comment on it. It's actually, the way that I'm looking at this, it's sort of deteriorating. It's a process that suddenly, in my eyes, it begins to deteriorate, and I'm thinking, oh, do they really look like flames? They look more like, some sort of underwater algae, But you have to be critical, but you also have to take it easy. You can't just drive yourself crazy. The little bit of freehand there, what I call freehand, which is doing these jiggly lines. The standard name for it, of course, is dagger lines, but with a little bit of wiggle. to them. So, you know, the shine, by the way, it's the effect of the candy on the spoons. So, as you've seen, I mean, it's taken me the whole day to do this. And certainly it's, you know, slowing down to videotape and get everything ready. It's a big pain, but it's also a pleasure to do. And I don't mind doing it, you know, as long as people enjoy it. And then you have questions and you ask, and we're here to answer them, you know. I go over this as well in the book. And I go over some of the equipment. And, of course, in the book, I thank Craig Frazier, who's been a lot of help with a lot of this, even though this is Mike Levelay's, you know, technique. But Craig's a master, and he knows how to create his own. You know, everybody comes up with their own style when you're dealing with the flames, you know. The spoon on the right, as you can see, or as I can see now from this vantage point, has lost all definition, you know. It's very hard to see what in fact is there that looks like a flame compared to the spoon on the left. So here I am trying to bring out a little bit more definition. And, you know, and sometimes, like I said, you lose it. You have to, practice. You practice. And then all of a sudden, it's like when you're ready to do it on your model, you hold your breath. And you dive in and you hope that it all goes well. The model, you know, since I've already put a lot of work into it, I'm probably not going to stop to video the whole process, but I'll definitely make a video of what I did or will do to the model and then go over it. But this is the process. It's just transferring it over to the model. So practice on your spoons. And you're gonna be just fine. So practice. Yeah, definitely the spoon on the right. I have no idea whatsoever. Probably in the second part of this video, you'll hear me complain about it. And but you know, again, it's just catching up. And
all right, guys. Let me show you what we've got here, okay? We, you know, it's very easy to lose your way doing this kind of paint job and start losing your definition, okay? And you'll see it here a little bit. We sort of lost our way with the licks, okay? And this one's all right, you know, but it's a matter of pushing back and then bringing, you know, you could repeat the process. You could also darken the background so that all of this stuff is into the background with more candy. The candy, of course, is going to darken your base coat a little bit. Unless if you use black, then it would disappear into the black. But you know, it's gonna darken enough, and then you can come back and keep picking out the licks. So this is pretty much the basic idea. As I said, you know, you have to clear coat it, and then, you know, a lot of it will pop out. And but you know, personally, I'm not happy with these. And so the point is that, you know, hey, they're just plastic spoons. You could easily throw them out. This is not the model, you know. So but we'll see. We'll keep practicing, and hopefully by the time I get it over to the model, It'll be much better, and again, unless you did this all the time, which would again be tedious and it would drive you crazy, and eventually you get bored of it. You get really good at it, but then you get bored of it because it's the same thing over and over and over. You know, it's kind of fun to do. So let me know if you have any questions, and thanks for watching. Next up, I guess we'll try it on the model and see what happens, but that might be in a couple of days. So now I have a couple of flamed crazy spoons. I haven't finished the process, and that, you know, I have to, you know, you add clear coat to it eventually, and it'll be nice and shiny. But these are just spoons, so I don't want to waste the product on them. So anyway, Let me know what you think. All right, bye.